I know. It's been a long time, but I had to take a sudden break because of a personal issue. Sorry for the wait. As promised, here is the first part of the super big NamJin theory I have talked about. Be ready to get your mind blown. It will take quite some time to go through everything, but if you stay, you will not be disappointed. This is a theory, but the huge amount of evidence for it paints such a solid, logically consistent, and plausible picture that it is going to be very hard to dismiss the case as just coincidence or delusion. It's a great theory, and both NamJin fans and ARMYs will love it, as it not only explains why our beautiful NamJin is indeed very real and been hiding in plain sight all this time, but also finally gives you the answers to the many mysteries in the Love Yourself and Map of the Soul series that fans have been trying to find for literally years now. With the precious help of the wonderful G from the BTS theory blog G Theories, we'll in fact start first thing first with revealing BTS's works as the deep, meaningful, and multi-layer pieces they clearly were very intentionally crafted to be. Grab a snack, be sure to pay close attention, and enjoy. When you start looking at the album series with more attention, a clear picture of how they were originally meant to be interpreted by the audience will unavoidably start to form. And I think it is odd that nobody seems to have noticed yet. Everything about these albums seems to suggest one thing and one thing only. Everything, from their internal structuring to the way they have been titled, is more or less design choices. The amount of evidence is actually so great that it would be incredibly weird if this was all just a coincidence. Because as bizarre as it may seem, I think that the Love Yourself and the Map of the Soul series tell the real and undisclosed story of BTS. All through the eyes of the three members of the Red Line. Or better yet, the story of their long journey to self-acceptance that started the minute they met what they themselves seem to describe as the big love of their lives. The stage, or the spotlight, in J-Hope's case, Jin in NamJin's case, and BTS, or in the specific, the success and power achieved through BTS in Jungkook. I will explain in more details in a second, but first, let me specify one thing. Unlike most BTS theories out there, this one will not be about BTU. In fact, the BTU, or Bangtan Universe, narrates a completely different and unrelated story, a fictional one. With BTS reimagined as characters, inhabiting a fictional universe, and that has nothing to do with the real life BTS, obviously. This one will focus on real life Bangtan, and the secrets they have chosen to hide, in plain sight, all along. How? Well, let's take a look starting from the Love Yourself album series. These right here are the three physical album releases plus the digital release of Love Yourself Wonder. As we can see, in all cases, the series title, Love Yourself, is accompanied by a Chinese character that is different for each one of them. A common mistake is trying to interpret the meaning of the Chinese character in the title by itself alone, without taking into consideration the ones that appear on its companions. In fact, these characters, all put together, form a famous Chinese idiom, which is commonly used to describe what in literature is known as narrative structure. Narrative structure is the structural framework that specifies the order and manner in which a certain narrative/story is presented to a reader. And this is important, because it immediately tells us three very important things about the Love Yourself album series right away. Number one, that it is a narration/story. Number two, that each album is a different chapter of it. And number three, which one is actually the correct order for these chapters to be enjoyed in. As when looked at in relation to each other, in this idiom, the individual characters acquire the meaning of beginning, development, twist, and resolution.
which officially reveals that love yourself, wonder, the one assigned the character meaning beginning, is actually a prequel rather than a sequel, despite being released after the others.
But this isn't all.
This, in fact, tells us another very crucial piece of information. Because if this is a narrative, and it needs to be read in a specific chronological order, it means that we, as the listeners, have to be following some character's progression through time. That this is some character's journey that we're looking at. And taking it one step farther, we can also make a pretty safe guess that this character's journey will be a journey towards self-love, as this seems to be the central theme of the series as implied by its main title. The subtitles, instead, written in English and coming after the double point when looked at one after the other, in the correct sequence, give away what is the driving force behind this character's journey. A love story. These are not just random words. They tell you what is happening, and it's these specific ones that have been chosen for a reason. Now, we will only get to truly understand this reason I'm talking about afterwards, while we go through everything, like the song lyrics themselves and all of that. But I think that you're still able to guess certain things just by looking at them. First chapter is called Wonder. To wonder means to ask yourself something, so we can assume that this story will begin with this character asking himself something. Assumption that is only validated by the ending chapter being called Answer, which implies both that we do actually begin with someone asking himself something, and that this someone will end up finding an answer in the end. Pretty obvious, right? But again, through the process of logical inference, we can also make another educated guess. The English word wonder also has another meaning, and that is a feeling of great surprise and admiration caused by seeing / experiencing something that is strange and new. That, coupled with the fact that the lead track of wonder is named Euphoria, and the fact that this first chapter of the story is followed right after by one called Pear, tells us that when we first meet him, the character is not only asking himself something, but also going through an intense emotional experience. That of meeting someone, a certain special her, that evokes in him a feeling of wonder and euphoria. At least initially, because since the next installment is called Tear, we can tell that problems with this her are bound to arise pretty soon after, turning the feeling of euphoria into one of sorrow. Again, using common logic, we can also advance the hypothesis, still only looking at these chapter titles alone, that being her and tear, the only ones separating those of wonder and answer, that the happenings narrated in them will probably be what will cause this unknown character to find an answer to the question he's been wondering about at the start of the series. And spoiler alert, it is. In fact, as we will soon see, everything else in this series only confirms this first vague hypothesis that could be easily made, only taking into account the title alone. Isn't this amazing? That is already a lot of information that they gave us only by paying extra care into titling these works the way they did. It's awesome, and I think it's worth to point this out because, other than it being pretty cool, this is in itself a crucial hint as to how we should go about solving this puzzle. Because this reveals to us one thing, and it is that titles are clearly very important here. And they have been strategically picked to be elements that can be used to extrapolate information from. This is essential, because now that we're aware of this, we can start to scan these works to see if we can find additional clues in the only other thing that has titles, the track. By observing the full and complete tracklist of the series present in the final album, Answer, it immediately jumps to the eye that there are three song titles which for some reason are different from all of the rest. The solos of the rap line, Trivia Just Dance, Trivia Love, and Trivia CISO. Each of the three is preceded by the word Trivia, and one of the Chinese characters that were present in the main title of the previous album. It's a peculiar choice, and as you might be able to imagine by now, there is a good reason for it. The theme of each song, coupled with the specific character used in the title, tells us that these songs are actually meant to be considered as additional entries of the previous chapters of the story. Trivia Just Dance, which was assigned the character meaning beginning, is an extension of the first chapter, Wonder. Trivia Love, which has the character for development, is an extension of Pear, while Trivia CISO, which has the character for twist, is instead an extension of Tear. Pretty obvious. What was harder was to figure out why the Latin word Trivia was chosen to be a part of the title. Having studied ancient Latin, I knew that Trivia meant three ways, or more specifically, was the word that ancient Romans used to describe a single main road dividing into three other ones heading into different directions. Which, initially, had me very confused, like, why? Why this sudden reference to roads and directions all of a sudden? And why did they want to bring this type of special focus to their rap line solo? Until now, every word choice and title was carefully studied to help people get a better understanding of how to interpret the series as it was intended. So I knew that there had to be a rational and logical explanation behind it that was coherent with everything else. Yet, I failed to find it. But Benji pointed out to me the one detail that I had missed and that turned out to be essential to figure out the true meaning behind everything. While attentively analyzing the lyrics for the only tracks in the series which are exclusive to the rap line alone, Outro Hair and Outro Tear for her blog, she picked up upon a strange lack of cohesiveness between the verses the songs are composed of. Basically, to put it very simply, while the entire series reads like the story of a single character, narrating the experiences he makes along his journey to the audience, here, in the two rap line songs in particular, we encounter what feel like repeated and abrupt shifts in perspective, suggesting the possibility of the existence of three narrating characters instead of just one.
Three different characters, each recounting its own personal experience involving its own hair. In fact, in their respective verses, the rap line members each seem to embody a very distinct point of view while portraying situations regarding this hair, or their feelings towards this hair.
Bringing us to hypothesize the presence of a different object of desire for each member of the trio. Hypothesis which is strengthened by the presence of something which has clearly been put there to help you figure it out. In Outro Tear, the rap line members use a different keyword over and over in their respective parts to summarize the completely personal way they think of their own hair as during the relationship's problematic phase. These keywords are fear for J-Hope, fear for Namjin, and terror for Yoongi. Three almost identical looking and sounding words that have completely different meanings and connotations. This is not a coincidence. It's meant to mirror the way their verses have been specifically crafted to share enough similarities to still be and sound part of the same song, while actually being about three separate and distinct emotional states.
deriving from having experienced problems with their objects of desire, each in a different way.
Which is again proof that words here are chosen very, very carefully and for a specific reason. This revelation changes everything. In fact, this one is the one thing that made everything else click into place for you. Because if what we're looking at here in these two songs really are three different characters and three different objects of desire, then there is the strong possibility that the entire series has never been the story of a single character. They have really gone out of their way to make us understand that all parts of the series are meant to be considered as a whole, after all. Even the drawings on this album's covers are made with a single line that never breaks, for example. Another pretty clever way that they have to subtly reinforce this idea. So, obviously, at this point, I unavoidably found myself wondering, what if this series was actually all along the story of three distinct and separate characters? Three characters sharing a similar enough journey towards self-discovery and self-love to be mostly easily narrated through a single tale. A tale that begins with them starting to wonder who they really are as people, after meeting with what they consider to be the big love of their lives, and that ends with them finding their answer to the joy and sorrow that this big love makes them go through. And what if this is not just any random trio of unknown characters, the self-discovery story we are looking at, but a much more familiar trio for us? Everyone's favorite swag trio, the BTS rap line. Since, as we will see in more detail soon, the self-discovery journeys I believe they went through in real life share many of the same faces and themes, they seem to have chosen to recount them through a single narration, opting to talk from their own point of view only when their situations and feelings differ too greatly for them to stick to the general formula. In Outro Hair and Outro Tear, obviously, but most noticeably, you guessed it, in their own solos, Just Dance, Love, and Seesaw, which are preceded by the Latin word trivia, used by ancient Romans to describe a single main road diverging at one point into three heading into different directions, because this is what is happening from a narrative standpoint. A single narration suddenly diverging into three separate ones, each describing a situation that is too personal and unique to their own journey to be squeezed into this one size fits all type of structure. If you think that these results are somehow due to chance, hold on before giving your judgment, because we have not even scratched the surface yet.
There are a lot of other hints that were intentionally left to guide you to the truth, and we'll get to see them in the next part.
Something which I'm really happy about, as mind-blowing and revealing these specific details just shared already are, I believe that this theory only gets better from this point onward. After all, I think that this theory is strong point, and the reason I personally have a hard time believing it's just coincidence is its incredible logical consistency. With big comprehensive theories like these, with analysis spanning over multiple works, the ability of a theory to be internally consistent is oftentimes, in itself, a strong indicator that you are onto something. In fact, not only the presence of every element in this series, and the following one, Map of the Soul, can be finally explained under this theory. But you'll also see how by simply playing connected dots, metaphorically speaking, with the pieces of evidence they left us, we can start to see a picture take shape. One so beautiful, in fact, that it is impossible not to think of it as the artistic expression of someone. But let's proceed step by step.